Let's take a closer look at that sum of strings function definition. Function definitions take the general form. We start with the func. Oops, not that func. So func followed by the function name, then a pair of parentheses. Inside the parentheses, you'll find the parameters, taking the form parameter name, colon, parameter type, then an arrow pointing to the return type, followed by the executable statements between curly braces. So if we look at our sum of strings method, we see that it takes in a parameter called a bunch of strings. That parameter is of type array, holding items of type string, and this function returns an object of type int. Let's look at another example. You've also seen this code before. The name of this function is reverse string. It takes in a string as a parameter named string to reverse, and it returns an object of type string. Keep in mind that not every function returns an object. For example, if reverse string printed out its result instead of returning it, the function signature would look like this. No return type, and since there's no return type, no arrow either.